My name is Vinit Bansode and I'm a graphologist. How many of you have heard of graphology before? Fine, and that is always the case whenever I go and talk to audience. So graphology is a science, and it is a science to read the handwriting and signature of a person and identify the thought process of a person. So when we say identify the thought process of a person, people actually wonder what do we really do. Because normally we talk in terms of, we read about character, we read about personality, we read about behavior. But what is this thought process that we do? So everybody has a thought process, and our thought process actually lead to something else. So graphology is a science to read the handwriting and signatures. But how the character or the personality or the behavior of a person comes? It comes from thoughts. If you have positive thoughts, you will have positive words. If you have positive words, you will have positive action. If you do one action regularly, it becomes a habit. And a set of habit, it actually called a character. So when we actually try to analyze the character of a person, we are actually identifying the thought process of that person. So many times what we know about people is the character, is the behavior, and not the thought process. Okay? So just a small question to all of you. Do you have anything in your mind which you have not shared with anybody in this world? Please raise your hands. Do you have anything in your mind which you have not raised with anybody in this world, right? And there are certain things you have decided you will never share it with anybody in the life, right? That will go to your grave. So if we have these things in our mind, so imagine everybody around us has certain things in his mind that he has never shared to anybody, right? So how can we say that I know this person very well? Does that statement really stand true, that I know this person very well? Because the person is allowing you to tell only those things which he wants you to know. So there are so many surprise elements about people that we never know, and that is why we get shocked that I never thought this person would do this. I never expected this person will be doing like this, you know. I never believed that this person would be dishonest. So when a person is honest and dishonest, when you say that I know this person for the past 20 years and he's extremely honest. So there are two meanings actually. One, he's really honest. Or secondly, maybe he's not got a real chance. You know, that is why people wait for something. So we have these surprises. So thought reading is a very difficult thing because you can only read behaviors, we can only read about the acts and the facts. But what about the thought process, the tendencies of a person that he can actually commit crime sometime in his life. He has that tendency. He has an ethical tendency in his life, which has not been used, but he may use it at the right time. So the most important thing, which is called the blind spot also. You know, blind spot is something inside you which controls you, but you don't know where it is. Like we all know what is your favorite color. Yes or no? We all know our favorite color. Now ask this. Do you know why is that your favorite color? And that we don't know. So do we know your favorite food? The answer is yes. But do you know why that is your favorite food? The answer is no, right? So there is a blind spot inside us which actually controls us, and that reaching that blind spot is the most difficult thing for any science, and graphology does that. It takes you to the root cause of your personality, behavior, thought process. So going ahead. So how does catalyst work? You know, so life is about knowing people. Your life is good if you have the right kind of people around you. Your life is pathetic if you have the wrong kind of people around you. And the most difficult challenge for people is to read people. How do I trust this person? How do I know this person is good, you know? And graphology actually reduces that space, which is like 2 to 3 years of space. Normally we take 3 years to know a person well. I personally feel even if you stay with a person for 25 years, you don't know the person, you know? But normally we say that 3 years, I know this person for 3 years, so we can be friends. But that process can be reduced to as less as 3 minutes with graphology. If you read somebody's handwriting and signature, you know everything about that person. From his childhood, his parents, his upbringing, his potential, his strengths, his weaknesses, his phobias, his tendencies, everything. And that is why it is called a catalyst, because it can reduce the time, it can fasten the process of understanding a person. It's a unique it's a snapshot. Like for the heart, there is an ECG. You know, when you connect the ECG to the heart, the doctor tells you that your heart is going through these issues, and because you abuse the heart, now it is in this condition. Or because you take good care, the heart is performing well. The same way, there is no ECG for the mind. And handwriting becomes the ECG for your mind. How is your mind functioning? How are your thoughts? Are they positive? Are they negative? How is your IQ? 300 things about you which you don't know. 300 things about yourself that you don't know can be identified by graphology. So it is a unique snapshot of what is your mental condition right now. It doesn't predict the future, because if you change your handwriting, and we will come to that, you can actually change the way you are in the future. Going ahead, so yeah, like the ECG and the mind. So we all know it. You know, we are all gifted with the gut feeling. If I ask you, these are two people, and if I ask you, which person do you think is a simple person, A or B, just quickly shout out. B, right? And when you look at the handwriting, when you look at the signature is simple, if the signature is complicated, it's something, it tells you something. A complicated signature is a complicated personality, as simple as that. And a simple signature is a simple personality. What is the proof? Because this is a science, we should talk about proof. All the freedom fighters, you know, how honest they were. Can we give them marks out of 10? How much marks can we give them out of 10? All the freedom fighters? 10, right? Now you can Google and check. All the freedom fighters have legible, clear, simple signatures, like a child. And because they were extremely honest. The problem of our country is that 95% of our politicians have a complicated signature. And that says it all, right? So if you have a simple signature, you are very sorted, simple. You know, your life is simple, your plans are simple, your relations are simple, your thinking is simple, your approach is simple, and your signature is simple. So the graphology says, the way you do one thing, you do everything else. So if you do a simple signature, there are tendencies, there are chances that you will do everything else simple. And if you have a complicated signature, you will do everything in a complicated way. But it is a blind spot, you will not even realize that you are doing things complicated. And you are right, because the signature was of Mother Teresa, and we know how transparent, how honest she was, and how peaceful she was. So clarity in signature also gives you peace of mind. If you want to be successful and honest and peace of mind is a rare combination. Honest, successful, and peace of mind is a rare combination that you get from a clear signature. So let us teach you, what do we see in handwriting? So everybody we learn the handwriting in school in four line book, right? Everybody has the same handwriting. As we grow, we develop our own style. And why does the style becomes individual? Because it is connected to your mind. So some people choose to write small, no matter how much the parents and the teachers shout that write big, and the teacher can't read and you will not get good marks. But you still stick to small handwriting. Why? Because people who write small are good in concentration, introvert, thinking, planning, secretive, academically oriented. So anybody who is highly educated, anybody who is into PhD, anybody has a higher degree, like 3-4 degrees, like a surgeon or a MD, he will always have a small signature. Very, very rarely you will find that somebody has a big signature and is highly qualified. Very rarely, very, very rarely, 0.1%. So small handwriting, but don't go by because I'm saying, we should have some proofs, right? So small handwriting are intelligent people, small handwriting are research oriented people, small handwriting are out of the box, intuitive people. Examples? Albert Einstein. The smallest handwriting in the world, you know. If you have the such handwriting, you can become Albert Einstein. But it will also give you other thing, which will be introvert, which will be, some kind of inferiority complex, some kind of social fear and things like that. So Albert Einstein, Charles Darwin. All these people who have done fantastic research work, all the patents that they have, it's because of the kind of tiny handwriting that they have. Napoleon, but these are all old original samples of all these people. So also we have big handwriting. So graphology is easy to learn, because if you understand one extreme, the exact opposite extreme is opposite of that. Big handwriting people are social, talkative, communicative, frank, right? So they like to meet people, they like to socialize, they like to party, they like to adventure, they like food, they like spending time outside the door rather than inside the door. What are the examples? All pastry people, all people who are in the social area, they'll always write big. They like people, and that's the reason they will be always outside. So all the film stars, all the people who are very socially confident, motivators, team leaders, they are like that. Now, again, so graphology is graph and logic. Graph is the graph and logic is the science. Now, all languages in the world can be divided into two parts, the way you write. One is angular handwriting and one is called an arcade handwriting or a soft handwriting or a garland handwriting. So angular handwriting is something which looks like this. So these people are shrewd, calculative, analytical and all those things. And for that, I'll show you one sample. Can I just pick up that? Can anybody read this word?
Minimum,
right? So actually, if you see, there is no spelling, there is no English in this. It's only, angles. Now people who could read this word are actually these kind of people, shrewd, calculative, ambitious. And that is why you could read this, because there is no English in this. But because you're thinking it like this, because you're used to that kind of writing, you are always looking at that. Can somebody hold? Stand here. So examples, if you are very shrewd, you are very angular, if your handwriting is very sharp. This is right from the age of 34, 1923 to the age of 29, 1945. All his signatures were angular and we all know how compassionate he was. So the moment you are angular, you become very shrewd. You can also check the signature of Donald Trump. Very, very sharp, very, very angular, right? So all these people are very powerful. They like position, they like money, they like domination, but they lack big time into relationships. So they can't be soft-hearted. They will be always, always, always mind. So they will make a lot of money. They will be very powerful. They will be very famous. But they, at the end of the life, they will not be having relations, to maintain. So angular handwriting. So if you see all the successful people, the signatures will be angular. They will not be rounded. Like children's write at the age of 3 and 4, that pattern nobody will write. So if you see these two famous people, the signatures are angular and that's the reason they could do actually a big company like that. Soft handwriting. So no child will actually write angular. Every child will always write very soft. If you see a 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 year old child, his book will be all rounded. And why rounded? Because he is soft. He doesn't understand all the logic of the world. So he'll be very compassionate, he'll be very jovial, he'll be very gullible, he'll be approachable, he will be caring, friendly and things like that. So all the personalities you see on the media also, you will see that this person is very soft, so his handwriting must be very rounded. Example would be Mother Teresa. Okay. Very, very soft, very understanding, very compassionate, very loving, mother kind of a feel. And Amitabh Bachchan also, you see his rounds, in the A and the B. You'll never see him losing anger, Even though he's called an angry young man, in day-to-day life, he's very humble. He's soft-spoken, he's very respectful and things like that. So what is the use of graphology? Why does graphology is so powerful? The most important question every human being all his life asks to himself is, who am I? What am I sent here for? What are my strengths? What is my job I'm supposed to do here? What is my potential? What is that one thing which I can, which is blessed in me? And what is that one strength which I can use and do a difference? So if you know that most of the time when we take our education, we take education of things like, which area has this potential now? Which career has the potential? Which growth? Which career has maximum growth? With graphology, it tells you that what is your real potential. So if you do this graphology test and you identify what is your strength, it will tell you this is the field you should work on. And this is the field you will actually be grown. So you save almost 7 to 8, 10 years. Like I was an engineer and then I realized my job is actually psychology. So I did 10 years of my career into engineering and then shifted to this. So I wasted 10 years of my life. If I had done this at the age of 16, I would have understood psychology is my passion. So employee selections, everybody these days attend a workshop called how to give interviews. They master that skill and they know exactly what to say in the interview and how to click the interview. The employer, poor guy, actually understands, the guy who gave a fantastic interview is actually good for nothing. So a company saves 20% of this kind of resources into wrong recruitment and we help them recruit the right kind of candidates. Aptitude testing for children, I think we spoke on this. Couple compatibility, If there is a small signature and there is a big signature, these are like two wheels. Small signature people are very protected, very shy, very insecure. Big signature people are very caring, very daring. They are high goal oriented, they are strong and things like that. Now if you have these two people coming together, any kind of compatibility, it could be team, it could be partners, it could be marriage. So one person will be dominating and one person will always be submissive. So we can actually predict that if these two people come together, what's going to happen? Okay. Couple compatibility. Child psychology, the best way to teach graphology or the best way to make changes in the handwriting is at the age of 7 to 14, 1-4. That is the time your brain is actually growing as a muscle. After 14, it stops growing. That's the reason what the signature that you did in the hall ticket in the 10th standard. That is the permanent signature stuck to you, and the signature is changing, but you are not able to come out of that. You know, the signature which you did at 10th standard, the format is same, but the look is different. Because now you have changed, but the signature is still old. So if you continue the same signature, mentally you are stuck to the 16-year-old child who designed the signature. So child psychology, criminal tendencies, I worked a lot with private detectives. There is a case, very famous case I solved of a robbery. There was a robbery in an office and I just analyzed the employees and we found out who was the who was the thief. These are some of my short story, these are my clients. Lastly, I would like to show you something. So anybody has a handwriting like this, raise your hand. If the first S is like this, when you write Suresh or you write success, the first S is like this. No? There are high chances, I haven't met you, I have not seen your handwriting, but there are high chances you will be the eldest son or child in your family. How many say true? Say shout yes.
Yes.
Right? Thank you very much.